Happening now in London, police are questioning four terrorism suspects believed to be members of ISIL. Now, the group was allegedly planning an attack in Britain. This as the U.S. investigates claims an American is involved in terror videos showing the beheadings of several people. The FBI said Wednesday it's received what it called a substantial number of tips about the identity of this masked ISIL fighter believed to be American or Canadian.
You can see them now digging their own graves in the very place where they were stationed.
The director said tracking down the dozen Americans recruited by ISIL is a top priority for the Bureau.
It's a huge focus of all of us in law enforcement, try to understand who's being recruited, who's flowing, who's looking to flow back.
President Obama was briefed by top military officials at the Pentagon today on the U.S. campaign against ISIL.
Our strikes continue alongside our partners. It remains a difficult mission. As I've indicated from the start, this is not something that is going to be solved overnight.
ISIL forces may be on the verge of taking control of a key Syrian town near the Turkey border.
Kobani is a place where the brutality of ISIL is on full display.
For days, Kurdish forces have tried to push back a ruthless ISIL advance, and the U.S. added support with airstrikes this week on ISIL targets in that area, including a half dozen on Tuesday. But this word of caution.
That air power is not going to be alone enough to save that city. The long-term fix is going to be competent ground forces that can retake territory from them.
The Obama administration insisted today, as it has for weeks, those ground forces will not be American. And by the way, the Pentagon says it is easy to get fixated on one town or one region even, but Americans need to look at the big picture to understand the U.S. campaign against ISIL. ABC 7 and our sister station News Channel 8 are hosting a special town hall on the ISIL threat. Your voice, your future town hall. It's the new terror threat. That's coming up October 16th. Watch News Channel 8 and also on WJLA.com from 8 to 9 p.m. You can visit WJLA.com/town hall if you'd like to sign up to join the audience.